Facing Waves was brought to you in part by Jackson Kayak. One family, many waters. Learn more at jacksonkayak.com.
This is flight safety. Remain seated with
Located in the Blue Ridge Mountains of North Carolina, Asheville isn't your typical southern town. A thriving mountain city, Asheville has a vibrant art community, an eclectic downtown, and one of the best natural playgrounds in the world for a backyard.
There's a lot of kayakers that live in Asheville or the surrounding area just because of the fact that you've got all these amazing restaurants and food options, and you've got this kind of hip scene between the bars and clubs and music scene and visual arts and stuff like that. So it's a really cool and unique place to be, and I think a lot of kayakers really enjoy that.
In the Southeast, you think really conservative, you think hunting, fishing, you know, Asheville's really artsy. It's a great place to live if you're an outdoor enthusiast. There's mountain biking, there's all kinds of activities here.
That and the fact that the Green River's right there, I mean, it's hard to beat.
Every fall, the Jackson clan makes their way to Asheville for a taste of the local rivers and to compete in the infamous Green River Narrows race.
The Green River is a pretty unique river. It's got a pretty big name in the USA and actually worldwide. It has several rapids that are extremely challenging and unique and really technical.
This sort of river is just full-on creek boating. It's got some drops, it's got some waterfalls that land on rock, just really technical, and it's a very pushy, kind of a tough run to really stay in control the whole time.
It's like the perfect day run, it's a perfect length, it's got a great warm-up, it's got a great warm-down, it builds up, and then you got your big rapids in the middle.
I think the original name for the rapid was Go Left and Die, but now everybody calls it Go Left or Die because all the locals now run it, and it's now the fastest line for the race and kind of one of these crux moves that everybody does now. But looking at it, you just kind of think, like, how is that even possible? Like, how do you make it through that rapid? But it goes better than it looks, I guess. Gorilla, in my mind, is probably one of the most intimidating, if not the most intimidating, rapid on the Green River. So the whole thing, it happens really fast, and it's pretty technical. But the notch, the entrance, is this little move where you've got to boof and keep your bow up and dry so you don't get pushed up against this wall or pushed right into this eddy or this other rock pile. So there's a whole bunch of variables right there, what can happen off this really little entrance move. And then the real consequence is, if you screw that up, you're gonna fall off this 15-foot waterfall that lands on rocks and possibly hurt yourself really badly. I mean, hundreds of people run it, and I always wonder, like, does everybody realize that we're all landing on rocks? Am I the only one that's even aware of this?
Lying, but I can't let a little hate crime ruin my night.
matter how good you are, these rapids continue to scare you and you have to learn how to control yourself in the rapids. And so I think having a race here, one of the most technical and hardest races in the world.
You throw in this race and it changes the whole kind of game plan and thought process to the river. Instead of just like, can you make it down the river? Now it's more like, oh, can you win the race? Are you good enough to win?